So to those changes. Michaelia Cash will be Australia's next Attorney General and Minister for Industrial Relations. She has done an outstanding job for our government. She is a fine attorney and she is a fine parliamentarian. And I'm looking forward to her leadership in this role, as she also holds the position of Deputy Leader of the Government in the Senate in recognition of her significant talents. Linda Reynolds will remain in Cabinet and will take on the portfolio of government services and the National Disability Insurance Scheme. I've been in regular contact with both Linda and her doctor with her permission, and she has recovered extremely well. And we have discussed her return to work and agreed that a domestic portfolio would be best for her, but she is in good health and I know she will do an outstanding job in this area. She has previously served on the committee for the NDIS and knows those issues extremely well. Peter Dutton, who has done an extraordinary job as Minister for Home Affairs. He was the first Minister for Home Affairs in a very, very long time. He succeeded me in the portfolio of Immigration and Border Protection many years ago, and he has carried on that great work. The boats are stopped, he kept them stopped, and he has moved in so many other areas of that portfolio. He will take on the job of Minister for Defence, and he will also take on the job of Leader of the Government in the House. And Christian Porter will take on a new portfolio for Industry, Science and Technology. I've spoken to this about Minister Porter over the course of these last few weeks when he's been on mental health leave. This fully addresses all the issues that relate to the advice received from the Solicitor General, as well as the advice received from the Department of Prime Minister and Cabinet regarding the ministerial guidelines. He's a very capable minister, and I'm sure he'll apply his considerable talents to that portfolio to the best of his abilities. I mean, people in this place who know Linda Reynolds would have been as shocked by her comment as much as that it was she who was making it. It was an intemperate remark made at the wrong time for all the wrong reasons, and she has completely apologised for that sincerely. That apology has been accepted and the issue has been resolved. And so that's where that matter rests. And so it is now a matter for the government getting on with that job and for Linda to be able to take up new responsibilities. I mean, she was previously serving as the Minister for Defence. That's a